All right, chaps, we've got a pair of DCOEs here. We're going to tune them using an airflow meter, and we're going to film it to show you guys how you can do this and how you can balance your twin carburettors on a four-cylinder inline engine. In this situation, it's a Pinto engine, and a lot of you have Pintos. So if you've got a set of twin carbs, you can use this airflow meter to balance them ready to then take on a rolling road, because we'll save you a lot of money and time when you're on the rolling road. All right, so here goes. We're going to fire it up. It's going to sound like a bag of shit, and slowly we're going to improve it using the airflow meter, balancing the spindles, and yeah, then it'll be ready to go on the rolling road. Keep watching. Go. So this is often what your engine will sound like when you first put a pair of 40s on it. So whatever engine you got, this doesn't sound too bad, but it is out of balance. We've done that on purpose. But the first thing to do is to obviously mess around with the throttle linkage, which is very important and time consuming, but that needs to be done right. Then you take your air filters off, and you set the idle as best as you can, and then you use the airflow meter to balance the two spindles so both carburettors work in harmony.
A lot of time has already been spent to make sure to check the fuel pressure, that's okay. We had air leaks on this pipe here, which we cured now. The breather wasn't working, which we've done. We've tightened up all the carbs because I was moving. So as a thing now, we just check, we're going to balance one carburettor to the other carburettor. So first we check the one, which is just under 2.5. So we then check the other carburettor, which is just under 7. This is your leading carburettor, and this is the one you'll adjust by looking at this linkage here. So if we put the meter back into this carburettor.
Can you show them that linkage again?
Yeah, this is the linkage we adjust here. That's right. The fixed one. This is the one to adjust for this lever here.
Okie doke.
So we put the synchrometer back in the carburettor to adjust. And using the screwdriver with the screw there, we can then turn it.
We need some more throttle. He's adjusting the idle there. Idle speed, yeah?
Yeah. So you can see now we're starting to rise the air. Probably just bring a little bit more throttle on. So now we're at 5, so now we check that compared to the original carb, which is just over 5. Give it a little rev, just clear it in. Already it sounds better.
That's picking up a lot quicker.
Yeah. Set that back in there. Clearing up dead on 5. Slightly over on that one. Just bring that out a little tiny bit. You heard the revs drop?
Yep.
Probably gone a bit too far to come down to 4. It's just a thing of keep checking. Turn that back up a touch.
What are these, DCOE 40s, yeah?
Yeah, DCOE
40s.
Just under 5. Over 5, keep.
When he says under 5, that's 5 kilograms of air per hour in that cylinder. Dead on 5, what's that one?
Yeah, it's dead on 5.
Lovely, let's hear it.
So just drop the idle there,
yep.
Ever so slightly.
Yep.
Give it a nice little red.
All right.
And that's what happens when you've got broken linkages.
Damn. That was a good close off, man. Well, that was close. Troubleshooting, ladies and gents.
This is what all
every day
happens with carburetors.
Living as a tuner.
If you look here, it's popped out of the linkage. As you can see, the cable has already had
these
the tape
are
put around it.
Dangerous, man.
If you put back on there, we're back to where we were.
Try it again, man. That's better. Woo!
So there's your genuine cable and genuine fittings.
Has this happened to you before, mate?
It does happen, yeah. It does happen. Obviously, someone tried to put tape around there and obviously the cable's not being pulled from the throttle.
So I suppose if you're using it from properly from the accelerator pedal,
yeah, it wouldn't have happened.
You wouldn't get that.
Obviously, you should probably disconnect the cable while you're sort of trying. But
okay.
It's rare that sort of happens.
That's scary. That is, man.
If you look at what they've got here and stuff, it's not an ideal setup at all. It's
no.
It's a home-built car, and
we're trying to do the best we can.
We have already put a nut on the back of here.
Okay.
To try and help. But,
yeah. You know. Right. Well, I'm glad I wasn't alone when that happened, man. Don't do it again. Go in the car, man. Anyway, I can get that. That sounds good. Okay. Right, the Chris, tell them about the actual specific situation with these carburettors, man. What you told us earlier on.
Basically, what we're doing is synchronising this carburettor to this carburettor.
Yeah.
You can check each spindle in the carburetor. Check those two, they are exactly the same.
Yeah.
If we look at this one.
Right.
We're at the just under 5. You go to this one, and we're just under 4.
Right, so what does that tell us then on this carburetor?
That tells you that we've got a different vacuum pull on this cylinder. So it's either a case of, if you look here, the brake servo is connected to it, so that could be drawing a vacuum.
Right.
But we have pulled that off and checked that.
Yeah.
So other than that, it could be that the spindles are bent.
Which is the worst case scenario, isn't
it? Yeah, two flaps inside, one a bit at one point, one a bit at another.
Okay.
We're getting a different air through. This case being is probably shut a little more. And if we go to what you do then after you've set your balancing, it's basically go to each cylinder. And adjust your idle air. So as you screw the cylinder.
That's cylinder 3, right?
Yeah.
That's the idle mixture.
Yeah, you'll hear the cylinder drop. So that's telling you that the idle system is working. So you wind it back out. And you'll hear the cylinder come back on.
And then wind it a little bit back in again.
Yeah. You'll do the same with this one. Drop off.
Yep. So cylinder 2 are not working right there.
No, it is working,
yep.
It should drop off.
Right.
So you wind it out then, you'll hear the engine pick up and try and smooth out. This will be a fine tune on each cylinder.
Okay.
If we go to number 4 and wind that in.
Which is the trouble,
this
the trouble
is the
there.
The trouble one, yeah.
Nothing's happened. Yeah.
Nothing happened.
So what does that tell you then?
So I think that's either going to be that the idle system has got a blockage, the idle air, or if the spindle is bent, that the flap's nearly shut, so it's not giving us the adjustment. That's why we've still got an ever so slight scuttle on the engine.
Okay.
So this all has to be done before it can go on the dyno.
Yeah. Got you. Where's your... here you go. Nice little Mark 1 Escort. Half of it there. Let's have a look at... Mr. RRS, there we go. Mr. RRS Rolling Road Services, there you go. This gentleman will hopefully put your carbs make them sing. Right. One more thing. The STE, the airflow meter. Where is it? Can you show me the adapter? What we had to use the adapter here. Where is it? There it is.
Yeah.
Basically, so, as you buy the synchrometer, it will come as that piece.
Yeah.
Obviously, you get some vehicles that...
You won't fit?
Yeah, got basically. You. So,
okay, especially not on this one.
Yeah, especially not on that one. So then, you can get the adapter piece.
Right.
Which, just put that into.
Yep.
And obviously, that's got a taper on it then, to fit snugly in a carburettor trumpet.
For restricted areas. Yeah. Okay, so you're going to try and tune this car now, yeah?
Despite
the fact that it's got a... Might be a bent spindle. You're trying to get it as best as you can.
Check the spark plugs. So obviously, that is more of a low down thing. At the top end, it's your low down throttle, and obviously, you can see the slight stutter on the engine.
Yeah.
Once you get onto the main jets, obviously, you'll just have a slight difference on the flap, so there'll be a slight air difference. But as long as it's not, you know, it's not a lot because it's only slightly out.
Okay.
It shouldn't make too much difference, but you check the spark plugs as you do it.
Have you been using this for a long time?
Yeah, so you can't tune carbs really without one of these.
Spot on. Let's just see. Thanks a lot, chaps. Thanks for watching. That was a scary moment just there. Nearly blew up a customer's car. Thankfully, it didn't. All right. Thanks a lot. Send us your comments, likes, and shares. And if you need a synchrometer, airflow meter, give us a shout. Cheers, Chris.